Good morning. It is Wednesday, November 17th. Our warm-up is a Canvas quiz. The agenda is Unit 5, Lesson 3, List Practice. Okay, we're going to go in and do our practice circles. They will be graded. It's going to be practice prep. What is due is your U5L3 List Practice. That'll be today. And students will be able to practice how a list can be used in an app. Sorry for the practice. Okay. We're going to open your code.org. You want to go to Unit 5, Lesson 3, Lists Practice. Okay. Vocab review. What is a list? What is an element? What is an index? We'll wait for answers. Start again. Okay, a list is an ordered collection of elements. An element is an individual value in a list that is assigned a unique index. And an index is a common method for referencing the elements in a list or string using numbers. All right, debugging, the process of finding and fixing problems in code. Describe the problem. What do you expect it to do? What does it actually do? Does it always happen? Think an on event if it doesn't always happen. Hunt for bugs. Are there warnings, errors? What did you change most recently? Explain your code to someone else. A lot of times that helps. Remember the rubber duck. Look for code related to the problem, okay? Try solutions. Make a small change. Don't do anything drastic. Try checking your code after every line you write. Don't write four lines and then wonder why it's all not working. Document as you go. What did you learn? What strategies did you use? What questions do you have? Okay, you remember this drill. All right, debugging lists. Use the console log to track lists in the debug console. Click the arrow to see elements listed by index. Okay, look, you can put, so here you can put your list in the watcher. See here, you're evaluating my list, and here you're logging my list. That's two ways you can see what's in your list. Strings have indexes too. Var my string gets this or that. 0, 1, 2, 3, those are all indexes. So your string is indexed by letter. So mystring.length will give you the length of the string, which is 12. Mystring.substring, start to end, start comma end, returns a substring starting at start and going up to, but not including the end. So mystring substring 04 is just this, right? This is 0, h is index 1, I is index 2, and S is index 3. So 0 to 4, 4 is blank, is just this. My string, substring 5, comma 7 is or. Okay, that makes sense, right? All right, you are going into Unit 5, Lesson 3 on code.org and work your way through your levels. Read the code, create a list of a list of numbers for the list, my unlucky numbers. Use the console log to print the console. Okay. What aspects of working with lists do you feel clicked today? What do you still have trouble with? Okay, we are going into our make tomorrow, so make sure to mull over what is it that's not clicking.